Amen.
Hallelujah. I think we can do better than that. Hello? We can clap better than that. What about our Lord Jesus? Our Lord Jesus, hallelujah. Amen. Glory to Jesus. Thank you very much. I'm glad to see every one of you. Amen. My mind is not one, is not together. Hallelujah. My mind is not one. Amen. Hallelujah. But in other words, in my mind, I have nothing. Amen. But the Spirit is loaded. Amen. So in case of anything, hallelujah, I am not responsible. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. So let us turn to the book of Deuteronomy. Deuteronomy 1. Thank you, Percy, for the opportunity. Amen. Thank you. The Lord bless you. Deuteronomy 1. Deuteronomy chapter 1. We will read verse 6. Deuteronomy 1, verse 6. Then we will go to Deuteronomy chapter 2. We'll read verse 24 and 25. Verse 1, the Bible says, Deuteronomy, the Lord our God spake unto us in Horeb, saying, you have dwelt long enough in this mountain. Chapter 2, 24 and 25. Rise up, take your journey, and pass over the river Arnon. Behold, I have given into thy hand Sihon, the Amorite, king of Heshbon, and his land. Begin to possess it and contend with him in battle. This day, will I begin to put the dread of thee and the fear of thee upon nations that are under the whole heaven, who shall hear report of thee and shall tremble and be in anguish because of you. Father, we thank you for this opportunity, God, to hear your word. Lord, we release ourselves. We open up our spirits, our mind, Lord, to receive from you. For we know truly your word has declared that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeds from the mouth of the Lord. We thank you and we bless you. Holy Spirit, our teacher, take over and lead us into all truth. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise the Lord. This is the story of the children of Israel. We all know how God delivered them with a mighty hand from the land of bondage in Egypt. And 40 years are now over that they were wandering after they refused to take the land in Numbers 13 and 14. 40 years which the Lord declared that they shall wander, and all of those who are above 20 years shall perish, but those who are below under 20 years are now to go in and possess the land. And the prophecy that God had declared to his servant, their father, Abraham, was now in their sight. But there is a place that they had dwelt for a long time. And so God is commanding them that you have dwelt in this mountain. for a long time. It is time that you arise and take your journey and go and possess the land. Contend with those that possess the land that I have given unto you as a promise. And I will be with you, and I will put dread and fear to all the nations that are under heaven. It is a fulfillment of a prophecy. And we all know that each and every one of us has a word that God has spoken in his life. And I want to believe that the hour and the moment and the time has come for us to reap our prophecies. It doesn't matter the duration of the prophecy or when it was spoken. The word is still alive. It is waiting for you to arise. It is waiting for you to arise. Even as the word of God says, arise and shine. The hour to shine has come. For your light, the light of that word, the light of that prophecy has come. It doesn't matter how long it was spoken into your life. Every prophecy has its season and has its time. And I believe that we are in the moment and we are in the season of fulfillment of our prophecies individually and as a church and as a congregation and even as a nation. Hallelujah. As a nation, we are in that moment because a prophecy is spoken. It has time to grow. The prophecy has grown since it was spoken. It has grown. And now the hour for harvesting that prophecy has come. We are the ones who are entering into other people's labor. And we are the ones who are going to harvest. Hallelujah. But for us to harvest the prophecy, there has to be three things. Number one, there has to be order. There has to be order. Tell your neighbor, there has to be order. Either as individually or as a church, there has to be order for that word to come and be manifested in our lives. Percy tells us normally that it is until that everything was in order in the rebuilding of the temple of Solomon that the glory descended. The glory will not descend on confusion. The glory will not descend on chaos. Hallelujah. The glory of God will only descend when everything is in order. And it is interesting, if you read in 2 Chronicles chapter 7, when Solomon was bringing the Ark of the Covenant into the temple so that he may offer a sacrifice that the glory might come down. There is the way they carried the Ark of Covenant, the way they carried the Ark of the Covenant. And interestingly is that Solomon never struggled. Hallelujah. Solomon never struggled with bringing the Ark of the Covenant like his father. His father struggled. In fact, even somebody had to die. It had to be relocated into another place for three months, that he might seek, that David might seek the due order, according to the way God had ordained that the Ark of the Covenant should be bared. David declared and said, it is because we did not seek him in due order. Due order. There has to be order. Your life has to have order.
the judge, hallelujah, and every department, hallelujah, there has to be order. Tell your neighbor, there has to be order. So for us to fulfill our mandate, for us to reap the harvest, order is necessary. And you will find that in the book of Numbers. Numbers chapter 1, verse 52. The Bible speaks of, and the children of Israel shall pitch. This is Moses ordering the children of Israel to be in order. Ordering the children of Israel to be in order. And the children of Israel shall pitch their tents, every man by his own camp, and every man by his own standard throughout the host. Throughout the host. Standard, order, and family in their camp. And if you read in Numbers chapter 2, verse 34, the Bible says, and the children of Israel did according to all that the Lord commanded Moses. So they pitched their tents. They pitched by their standards. And so they set forward, everyone after their families, according to the house of their fathers. Having remained in the same position for a long time, God says, it is enough. You cannot continue to dwell in this place. You cannot continue to act the way you have been acting, because your moment of being in this place is over. It is time to go forward. It is time to go and possess your land and possess your possession and see the realization of the promise of God in your life. But God has a word for every one of us. He has a word for the church. He has a word for the nation. And the children of Israel, the Bible says that they did according to all that the Lord commanded. There is a commandment of what we ought to do for us to possess our possession. And so the Bible says, and they set forward after they were in order according to the commandment of the Lord. They set forward. They charged. Hallelujah. They arose and began to contend in battle and to possess their land. Hallelujah. Numbers 24, verse 1 and verse 2. The Bible speaks of Balaam. And when Balaam saw it pleased the Lord to bless Israel, he went not as other times to seek enchantments, but set his face towards the wilderness. And Balaam lifted up his eyes and saw Israel abiding in his tents according to their tribes. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon Balaam. Hallelujah. They are in their journey. And Balak had called Balaam to curse the children of Israel. But when he lifted his eyes and saw Israel, when he lifted his eyes and saw Christ witnessing church, when he lifted his eyes and saw the praise and worship team, when he lifted his eyes and saw the media team, when he lifted his eyes And so the Sunday school, when he lifted his eyes and saw the ashes, when he lifted his eyes and saw the congregation, when he lifted his eyes and saw Israel abiding in his tents according to their standards throughout the host, the Spirit of the Lord came upon him. It doesn't matter what the enemy is planning to hinder his opposition, whatever his plans, as long as there will be order in our lives, as long as there will be order in every department, as long as there will be order in your life as an individual, whatever the enemy has planned for evil, God will turn it for good on your behalf. And we will testify together with Joseph, and we will declare, you thought it for evil, but God turned it for good. So it doesn't matter what the enemy is trying to do. The power of his advancement is not in his hands. And that is why the Bible says that no weapon that is fashioned against you shall prosper. Why? Because God says, I am the one who made, the one that fashions the weapon. I am the maker of that man that is going to be used to use that weapon. That man that will be trained to use the weapon, and the maker that fashions the weapon. I, God, I am their maker, and I will not stop that man that is being trained to use the weapon. I will allow him to take his time and exercise and train. And the one that fashions the weapons, I will not stop him from fashioning the weapons. I will allow him to continue to fashion the weapon. But as long as my people are in order, they are in their tents according to their standards, no weapon that is fashioned against them that shall prosper. Because whoever comes to curse, I will release my spirit and he will bless rather than cursing. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So what does it mean to pitch tents by their tribes, by their standards, by their families and their fathers? If you read in Genesis chapter 49, from verse 1 to 28, the Bible says, and Jacob called his son, Israel called his son, and said, gather yourselves together, that I may decree, that I may speak forth, that I may prophesy, hallelujah, to you, that which shall befall you in the last days. Hallelujah. They were blessed. Every tribe were blessed. They were blessed, every one of them, as a tribe. And in that blessing, in that declaration, in that prophecy, everyone was positioned according to their strength. Everyone was conditioned or was catapulted to a position by their strength through the prophesying of the word of their father in their lives. Deuteronomy 33 speaks of Moses blessing the children of Israel. In other words, that word that was pronounced, that prophecy that you are leaping, hallelujah, because a time to harvest has come. That word, hello, that word will set you if only you will align yourself according to that word that was spoken concerning your life, or has been spoken, or has been continually spoken, or you have been reading it for the word of God. The Bible says it's a sure prophecy. It's a word of prophecy. The written word is a word of prophecy. Hallelujah. It will position you. And wherever it positions you according to your strength. It positions you according to your strength. So when Balaam looked at the children of Israel and saw them the way they were arranged, hallelujah, the Bible says that their order was that they were to be around the tabernacle. Hallelujah. They were to be around the tabernacle. And in every side of the tabernacle, the four sides of the tabernacle, there were three tribes in every side. In the east, in the west, south, and north. And in the north part of the tabernacle were the children of Judah, and hallelujah, were the children of Judah in the north. On the north side were the children of Judah, the side of the north were Judah, who are many. They were many than any other children, plus the others. Hallelujah. And so when Balaam looked at them from where he was, he saw the pattern. He saw a pattern of the cross. Hallelujah. What he saw was a pattern of the cross. And our lives are ordered according to the cross. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, our lives are ordered according to the cross. So he saw, it is the cross that shall order us. The cross. Hallelujah. It is the cross of Christ that shall order us. And that is why Jesus said, if any man wills to be a follower of me, let him take his cross. Hallelujah. Let him take his cross and follow me. If fulfillment, hallelujah, of the word of God is going to take place, then our order is according to the cross of Christ. Our order. Tell your neighbor, your order is according to the cross of Christ. And so, for us now, to be in order, there has to be a shifting. Tell your neighbor, a shifting. For the children of Israel, it was a physical shifting. It was physical. Hallelujah. But for us, it is not physical. Although at times it might require us that we shift physically. But for the children of Israel, for example, you will know that for the word of God to be fulfilled in the life of Abraham in Genesis chapter 12, verse 1 and 2, the Bible says, and the Lord God has said to Abraham, hallelujah, get out of your people, your country, your kindred, your father's house, and go into a place where I will show you. There I will bless you. Hallelujah. There I will bless you. And even as we are shifting spiritually, I believe that there is a physical ordained position by God for our lives where we are supposed to be. I told someone, as long as you are in your station where God has ordained, everything that God has for you will find you in that station. It will find you. Hallelujah. Joseph could not fulfill the promise or the prophecy of his word in his life as long as he was in Canaan. He had to go to Egypt because that was the position where the word was spoken. by God to Abraham, your children will be in a foreign land under bondage in a foreign country. Joseph had to go physically for a manifestation or a reaping of his word. His word. His word that was that his brothers will come and bow before him. He had to be in Egypt. Hallelujah. Ezekiel 37, the Bible speaks of the dry bones. The dry bones. And the Bible says, when Ezekiel prophesied, that bone came to his bone. Order. Tell your neighbor, order. Bone came to his bone. Hallelujah. Everyone was positioned according to his stripe and standard in the house of their father. No bone that went to the wrong place. Hello? For an army to go and possess. This was a spiritual. Hallelujah. For an army to go and possess spiritually, there had to be order. Every bone was supposed to be where it is supposed to be and to function according to its positioning. The bone of the leg was not complaining that it is at the leg. It wants to be at the hand. That is the only thing that is messing us. Hello? Tell your neighbor you cannot be the whole body. Amen? You cannot be the whole body. You are a member. And you have to be in your position. Hallelujah. The present worship has to be at its position. Everyone. Amen. And everyone in the team has his place. And let everyone take his place. Hallelujah. And when everyone takes his place, you see, the present worship is a very, very sensitive department. Hello? Because God says that he inhabits the praises of his people. It is this that sets the standard of the atmosphere in this place. They determine the atmosphere. Hallelujah. They determine the atmosphere that is in this place. So, if they are not in order, then don't expect the move of God. Don't expect the Spirit of God. There is no order. Order is required. Amen. Be at your place. Do what you can do. Allow whoever can do whatever he can do, where he can do, let him do. Hallelujah. Jesus, victory belongs to Jesus. Hallelujah. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory does not belong to me or to Pascal or to Stano or whoever. Victory belongs to Jesus, and we are here for one reason and one purpose, to glorify Jesus. It is Jesus that has ordered us to be here. We didn't bring ourselves here. We are ordered. There are other many places that we can be, but because that is not where we are supposed to be, that is why we are here. And we came here with a reason. We have a reason. I have a standard. You have your own standard. You have your own place. Please. Hallelujah. I am not responsible. Praise the Lord. The Bible speaks of Matthew chapter 23. I'm about to be through. Amen. The Bible speaks of Matthew. Matthew 2:23. Hallelujah. Speaking of Jesus. Speaking of Jesus. Hello. After he was called by his father from Egypt. After he was called from Egypt by his father to come back to where he was supposed to be. He was supposed to be in Judea. Hallelujah. Because the Bible speaks of that is where Joseph came from. Hallelujah. But when he heard that the relatives or those who sought him when he was a child were still there, he was afraid. The Bible says he was afraid. And so he went to Galilee in the city of Nazareth. Hallelujah. Why? That it might be fulfilled that which was prophesied, that he shall be called a Nazarene. Relocation. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, relocation. Hello. Praise the Lord. There has to be a shifting. Tell your neighbor, there has to be a shifting. So, every one of us has his own place. We are members in the body. Amen. Hallelujah. And you cannot fulfill your purpose as long as that is the intention of your life, which defines your function or your assignment, as long as you are not in the place where God has ordained for you to be. Amen. And that is why Genesis chapter 3 verse 14, the Bible speaks of God asking Adam, Adam, where are you? Hello? Not that Adam was invisible. Adam was not invisible, that God could not see him. He also knew where Adam was. But when he was asking, where are you? That is the question that we are being asked today. Where are you? Arise. You have stayed in this position for a long time. This is not where you are supposed to be. You are supposed to rise and walk through the land and possess your possession. And now God is asking, where are you? Not because he cannot see you, but because you have been dislocated from your position. Adam was dislocated from his position spiritually, where God had ordained that predestined state of the position of Adam. He was dislocated by disobedience. The Bible says, when the children of Israel did according to the command, when they did all that the Lord God commanded, when they did all, hallelujah, when they did all, but Adam was disconnected for disobedience. Disobedience will dislocate us. And that is why we are saying there is a necessity of a shifting. Maybe you have been dislocated from where you are supposed to be. Hello? You have been dislocated, or you have moved from your predestined position according to the standard, according to the word of God, so that you may harvest. The intention is to harvest your promise, to harvest your prophecy, that word that has been spoken to your life. God is asking Adam, where are you positionally? Where are you? You are supposed to be in authority. You are supposed to be in charge. You are supposed to be in command. You are supposed to be calling the shots. Why are the shots calling you? Ask your neighbor, why are the shots calling you? Who are the shots? You are supposed to be calling the shots. Hallelujah. You are in charge spiritually. Hallelujah. Adam was dethroned. He was dethroned. Hello? But, tell your neighbor, but the cross of Jesus, the cross that is ordering our lives, the cross of Jesus that is ordering our lives, came, Jesus, the Bible says, came to seek and to save that which, not those, but that which, that predestined position that you lost, Jesus came to seek and save that and save you and bring you back to that predestined position spiritually. And now you are more better. You are more better. You are more better than Adam. Why? Because Adam ruled the earth and the second heaven. Hallelujah. But you are seated with Christ in the heavenly places, far above, in the third heaven, at the right hand of God the Father. That is where you are seated spiritually. I say there need to be a shifting. Tell your neighbor, a shifting. Spiritually, you are in the right position. But your soul, you see, salvation is in three parts. There is the soul, the spirit that you are you are regenerated instant. Hallelujah. But your soul, where your mind is, where your emotions are, where your will, your emotion, and your intellect, your mind are, it is gradual. Tell your neighbor, it is gradual. It is gradual. Your body will be saved. Tell your neighbor, will be saved. Your body will be saved when rapture will take place. That is when your body will be transformed. Hallelujah. But now, we are speaking of a shifting in the soul, your soul, where your will, your intellect, and your emotions are. I'm through now, Pastor. Hallelujah. Romans 12. Romans 12, the Bible says, be transformed. Amen. Be transformed. Hallelujah. Be transformed. Be transformed by the renewal of your mind. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, be transformed by the renewal of your mind. So transformation, a shifting. We are speaking of a shifting so that you may harvest your prophecy, your promise. A transformation has to take place. And a transformation only takes place by renewal of your mind. Renewal of your mind. Hallelujah. You see, that word transformation means change of nature. Change. Change of nature. There are two words, trans and form. Trans means to travel. Travel. Transit. Transport. Trans means to travel or a journey. Hallelujah. So, for a change. Amen. For a shift. Hallelujah. For a shift to take place, there has to be a trance, a travel, a journey, not physical journey. Hallelujah. Like the way Joseph went down to Egypt, or Abraham left his father's children. Hallelujah. This is a spiritual, like the bones of Ezekiel. There has to be a trance. There has to be a journey, a travel of your mind. Tell your neighbor, your mind. Hallelujah. There has to be a travel. There has to be a journey in your mind. You see, when I looked at this word, it amazed me, because the previous day, that was on Friday, I was praying here. We were here praying. Hallelujah. And I was coming against hindrances and barriers and positions in the name of Jesus. I rebuke you, hindrance. You are hindering me. Any barrier, any opposition, you will not hinder me. I am unhinderable. You see, at times when you are in prayer, you speak even you invent language. Hallelujah. Amen. Then, when I read this word, I realized that these barriers are not physical things that are beyond, that are outside of me. They are here. So I wondered, what was I rebuking? Hello? They are in my mind. Hello? Now, for me to overcome those things that seem as barriers and opposition and hindrances in my life, then I have to trance. I have to travel, not physically, but in my mind. Hallelujah. In other words, if I can travel within, hallelujah, I cannot stand still without. If I can travel within, if I can travel in my mind, then without, the physical world cannot stop me. So please join me. Let us stop binding hindrances and rebuking barriers. They are not outside there. Hallelujah. There has to be an altar in my mind to trance. Hallelujah. Now, for your travel or your journey is determined by the mode of your trance. The mode of your trance determines your journey. Because maybe you are on foot. Somebody who is on foot cannot be equal with somebody cycling. Hello? And one who is cycling cannot be equal to one in a motor vehicle. Hello? Neither can he that is in a motor vehicle be equal with one who is on an aeroplane. Their mode of trance determines the speed of their travel or their journey or their arrival. You have been designed to fly, whereas your mode of trance is foot. Hallelujah. So you have to change the mode of your trance. You have to change. You have to change the mode of your trance. Hallelujah. Because if you change the mode of your trance, then, hallelujah, the mode of your trance here in relation to our message is your cross. Your cross. Your cross is the mode of your trance. Hallelujah. Your cross is the mode of your trance. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, change the mode of your trance. It depends. Hallelujah. It's not in the word form. There is trance and form. As you trance, you are forming. Hallelujah. As you trance, you are forming. Hallelujah. As you trance in your thoughts, you are trance, you are forming as you trance. Philippians chapter 2 verse 5. Let this mind, let. That word let is asking for permission. Let me pass. Let. He's asking for permission. So God is saying, let, allow. Give access, hallelujah, to this mind, Philippians 2:5, that was in Christ, be in you. This mind that was in Christ, be in you, hallelujah, by taking the cross, denying yourself, hallelujah, praise the Lord. Then you will declare together with Paul in 1 Corinthians chapter 2 verse 6, but we have the mind of Christ, we have the mind of Christ. How do we attain this mind of Christ? 2 Corinthians 3 verse 18. I am finishing. But we all with an open face. We all with an open face. Beholding as in a glass the glory of the Lord. Are being changed. Are being transformed into the same image form. We are being changed. We are being tranced into the same image, form, from glory to glory. We are being tranced to the form of Christ from glory to glory as we behold. Let me finish with this. Let me finish with the mode of your trance. For you to be formed into the image from glory to glory. How many times do you eat breakfast, tea by 10? Lunch, I don't know whether you take tea at 4. Then in the evening, how many times? Hallelujah. How many times do you eat spiritually? Now we are talking of the mode now. The mode. You see, the way you eat, that is why you are the way you are physically. If you are, it's because of you. Hallelujah. Now, the question is, what about your spiritual? How many times do you eat? This is the trance now, the mode of your trance. The more you eat, the more you are transformed. The more spiritually, you see, do you see those people when we were growing up? The one we knew at that time, we used to call him Mike Ragos. Hallelujah. Those who do like this. Bodybuilding. God help. Ours is spiritual. Hallelujah. You do yourself spiritual. Hallelujah. Spiritual. Amen. So spiritually, how many times do you exercise? In prayer? In fasting? Because that is your mode. That is your trance. That the time that you take in doing these things is your mode of your trance. You can only be transformed as quick as your mode of your travel. You can only arrive as quick as fast as your mode is.